Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Emerald Sword of Captain Morgan. Chapter 1. The Quest Begins. In the year 1671, in the bustling port of Port Royal, a town infamous for its lawlessness and pirate denizens, Captain Henry Morgan, a name that struck both awe and fear in the hearts of many, prepared for a journey that could change the course of history. His ship, the Sea Serpent, a formidable vessel that had seen countless battles and adventures, was anchored in the harbor, its sails billowing in the warm Caribbean breeze. The air was thick with anticipation and whispers of the Emerald Sword, a legendary artifact shrouded in mystery and myth. Tales of the sword's power, said to command the wind and waves and turn the tide of even the most dire naval battles, had circulated among seafarers and adventurers for decades. But it was Captain Morgan, with his unmatched bravery and strategic mind, who dared to turn these tales into reality. As the crew loaded supplies and armaments, Captain Morgan stood on the deck, his gaze fixed on the horizon. He was joined by his most trusted allies, William Black Bill Turner, his first mate, known for his unmatched swordsmanship, and in Bonnie, a formidable pirate in her own right, whose wit and courage were as sharp as her blade. The crew of the Sea Serpent was a motley crew of seasoned pirates and young buccaneers, each drawn to Captain Morgan by the promise of adventure and the lure of untold riches. Among them was a young cabin boy, Jack, who idolized Captain Morgan and dreamt of his own legendary exploits. Before setting sail, Captain Morgan addressed his crew, his voice commanding and charismatic. He spoke of the dangers they would face, treacherous waters, rival pirates, and the unknown mysteries of the sea. But above all, he spoke of the glory that awaited them should they succeed in their quest. The crew, emboldened by their captain's words, shouted their allegiance, their voices echoing through the port. Their first lead took them to a small, uncharted island, known to only a few as a former hideout of the infamous pirate Calico Jack, rumored to have sought the Emerald Sword in his time. As the Sea Serpent approached the island, the crew prepared for the possibility of traps or ambushes. The island was a lush paradise, its beauty belying the dangers that lay within. Captain Morgan, Black Bill, and Bonnie, and a select group of crew members disembarked, venturing into the dense jungle that covered the island. They soon discovered an ancient ruin, overgrown with vines and moss, a relic of a time long forgotten. Within the ruins, they found carvings and symbols that hinted at the location of the Emerald Sword. The symbols spoke of a journey across the seas, of a storm that never ceased, and of a gateway to a world beneath the waves. It was a riddle wrapped in a legend, and its solution lay at the heart of their quest. As they deciphered the clues, they were unaware that eyes watched them from the shadows. The island was not as deserted as they had thought. A rival pirate crew, led by the cunning and ruthless Captain Bartholomew Black Bart Roberts, had followed them, intent on claiming the sword for themselves. A skirmish broke out in the ruins, steel clashing against steel, as Captain Morgan and his crew fought off Black Bart's men. The battle was fierce but brief, with Captain Morgan's crew emerging victorious. Black Bart, however, managed to escape, vowing revenge. The encounter was a stark reminder that the quest for the Emerald Sword was fraught with peril, not just from the sea and its mysteries, but also from those who sought the sword for their own nefarious purposes. Undeterred by the dangers, Captain Morgan and his crew continued their journey, guided by the clues from the ruins. Their next destination was the infamous Bermuda Triangle, a place feared by sailors and believed to be cursed. Legends spoke of ships disappearing without a trace, of strange phenomena, and of a hidden realm where the Emerald Sword was said to reside. As the Sea Serpent sailed towards the Bermuda Triangle, the seas grew rough and dark clouds gathered on the horizon. A storm was approaching, one that seemed unnatural and menacing. Captain Morgan stood at the helm, his eyes steely and determined. He knew that the heart of the storm would lead them to their next clue, and perhaps to the Emerald Sword itself. The crew braced themselves as the Sea Serpent plunged into the heart of the storm. Lightning cracked the sky, and monstrous waves threatened to engulf the ship. But Captain Morgan, with his unparalleled skill and unyielding will, navigated through the tempest. In the midst of the chaos, a miraculous sight appeared, an ethereal glow emanating from the depths of the sea. It was as if the storm itself was revealing the path to the sword. Captain Morgan steered the ship towards the light, the Sea Serpent cutting through the waves like a knife through silk. The Sea Serpent emerges from the storm, finding itself in calm waters that glittered with an otherworldly light. Before them lay a hidden cove, unmarked on any map, its shores shimmering with a strange, emerald hue. It was here that the next chapter of their quest would unfold, here that the secrets of the Emerald Sword would begin to unravel. Chapter 2. Clues from the Past. As Captain Morgan's ship, the Sea Serpent, anchored in the secluded cove, the crew felt a mix of awe and unease. The cove, with its emerald-tinted waters and an air of mystique, seemed like a place from another world. The crew, seasoned by countless voyages, knew this was no ordinary stop on their journey. Captain Morgan, along with William Black Bill Turner, and Bonnie, and a handful of his most trusted men, set out to explore the cove. The dense jungle surrounding the cove was alive with the sounds of exotic birds and unseen creatures, a stark contrast to the open sea they were accustomed to. Their exploration led them to an ancient temple, partially hidden by overgrown vegetation. Its walls were adorned with intricate carvings and symbols that spoke of the ancient civilizations that once thrived in the Caribbean. Among these symbols, Captain Morgan recognized motifs similar to those described in pirate lore about the Emerald Sword. Inside the temple, they discovered a series of murals depicting the legendary sword. The murals told a story of a time when the seas were ruled by powerful pirate lords, and the Emerald Sword was a symbol of ultimate power and authority. It was said to be crafted by a master swordsmith and imbued with mystical properties, able to command the forces of nature. As they deciphered the murals, they realized that the sword was not merely a tool of war but also a key to something greater, a source of knowledge and power that extended beyond the physical realm. The murals also depicted a map, showing the location of an island where the sword was last seen. This island, known as Isla de la Muerte, was shrouded in legends and feared by sailors. It was said to be a place of dark magic, where the line between life and death was blurred. Realizing the significance of this discovery, Captain Morgan decided to set sail for Isla de la Muerte. But as they prepared to leave, they found themselves not alone. A rival pirate ship, the Black Viper, commanded by the infamous Captain Bartholomew Black Bart Roberts, had entered the cove, drawn by the same legends of the Emerald Sword. A tense standoff ensued. Black Bart, known for his ruthlessness and cunning, proposed an alliance to find the sword, suggesting that it was too powerful for one man to possess. But Captain Morgan, aware of Black Bart's treacherous nature, declined the offer, leading to a skirmish on the shores of the cove. The battle was fierce but brief. Captain Morgan's crew, skilled and loyal, managed to fend off Black Bart's men, forcing them to retreat. However, Captain Morgan knew that this encounter was just a prelude to the dangers that lay ahead. As the Sea Serpent set sail for Isla de la Muerte, the crew prepared for the challenges that awaited them. The island was a place of myths and legends, where reality seemed to bend and the unknown lurked in every shadow. Their journey to the island was fraught with peril. The Sea Serpent faced not only natural obstacles like treacherous reefs and violent storms, but also constant pursuit by Black Bart's ship. It became clear that their quest for the Emerald Sword had turned into a race against time and enemies. During the voyage, Captain Morgan spent long hours studying the map and the legends surrounding the sword. He knew that finding the sword was only part of the challenge. Understanding its true power and purpose was crucial to their success. As they neared Isla de la Muerte, a sense of dread settled over the crew. The island, veiled in a perpetual mist, loomed ominously on the horizon. Legends spoke of it as a cursed place, where the spirits of the dead roamed and the living seldom returned. Undeterred, Captain Morgan led his crew ashore. The island was a labyrinth of dense jungles, steep cliffs, and hidden caves. The air was thick with the scent of rotting vegetation and the sounds of unseen creatures. Their search for the sword led them to an ancient fortress, nestled atop the island's highest peak. The fortress, a relic of a long-forgotten civilization, was said to be the last resting place of the Emerald Sword. As they ascended the peak, they encountered traps and puzzles, remnants of the fortress's ancient defenses. Each challenge they faced tested their wits and resolve, bringing them closer to their goal but also revealing the true nature of the island, a place where the past and present, the living and the dead, converged. Amidst these challenges, they also uncovered pieces of the island's history. It had once been a center of power, where pirate lords gathered to discuss their dominion over the seas. The fortress had been a meeting place, a council hall where strategies were formed and alliances were forged. As they reached the heart of the fortress, they found the chamber where the Emerald Sword was said to reside. The chamber, carved out of the living rock of the mountain, was a marvel of ancient engineering, its walls inscribed with tales of sea battles, pirate kings, and the mystical origins of the Emerald Sword. The air was thick with a sense of timelessness, as if the chamber had been waiting for them for centuries. In the center of the chamber stood a stone pedestal, bathed in a shaft of light that seemed to emanate from an unseen source. Upon the pedestal lay the emerald sword, its blade shimmering with an ethereal light, the emerald in its hilt pulsating as if alive. The sight of the sword was awe-inspiring, a testament to the craftsmanship and power of a bygone era. Captain Morgan approached the sword with a mix of reverence and caution. As his hand touched the hilt, a surge of energy coursed through him, a connection forming between him and the centuries-old legacy of the sword. In that moment, he understood the true power of the emerald sword. It was not just a weapon of war, but a conduit of knowledge and wisdom, a link to the collective experiences of those who had wielded it before. However, the moment of discovery was interrupted by the arrival of Black Bart and his crew, who had followed them to the chamber. A tense standoff ensued, with both sides realizing the significance of the sword. Black Bart, driven by a desire for power, demanded that Captain Morgan hand over the sword. What followed was a clash not just of steel, but of ideals. Captain Morgan, now understanding the responsibility that came with the sword, refused to let it fall into the wrong hands. The battle that ensued was intense, with the chamber echoing with the sounds of combat. In the midst of the battle, the emerald sword revealed another of its powers, the ability to command the elements. The chamber shook as if responding to the sword's presence, winds howling and the ground trembling. Captain Morgan, wielding the sword, used its power to turn the tide of the battle, defeating Black Bart and his men. With Black Bart's threat neutralized, Captain Morgan faced a crucial decision. The power of the emerald sword was too great to be wielded for personal gain. He realized that the sword needed to be protected, its secrets and powers kept from those who would misuse them. The story concludes with Captain Morgan and his crew leaving Isla de la Muerte, the emerald sword safely hidden away in a location known only to him. They returned to the seas, their legend growing with each passing day. The emerald sword of Captain Morgan became a tale told across the Caribbean, a legend of a pirate who sought power but found wisdom, a man who faced the mysteries of the past and chose the path of responsibility. As the sea serpent sailed into the horizon, Captain Morgan reflected on their adventure. He had sought a mythical sword, but had found a deeper understanding of the sea and the secrets it held. The sword's power, now safe from the world, would remain a legend, part of the rich tapestry of pirate lore that would continue to inspire and intrigue for generations to come. Chapter 3: Mysteries of the Deep. After the dramatic events on Isla de la Muerte and the hidden safeguarding of the emerald sword, Captain Morgan and his crew aboard the Sea Serpent set their sights on new horizons. The Caribbean, a vast expanse of water teeming with dangers and discoveries, was their playground and battlefield. Their journey took them through bustling ports where whispers of the emerald sword had spread like wildfire. In every tavern and marketplace, tales were told of Captain Morgan's encounter with Black Bart and the mystical powers of the sword. These tales, embellished with each retelling, turned Captain Morgan into a legendary figure, a pirate who had touched the untouchable and lived to tell the tale. But with legend came notoriety. The Sea Serpent and its crew found themselves the target of envy and intrigue among the pirate community. Rival captains, both awed and threatened by Morgan's growing legend, plotted against him, seeking to claim a portion of his fame and fortune for themselves. Amidst this backdrop of rivalry, Captain Morgan navigated the intricate web of pirate politics. He forged alliances with some and outwitted others, always staying one step ahead. His charisma and reputation as a strategist were his best assets, solidifying his status as one of the most respected and feared pirates of his time. One of their notable ventures led them to the shores of a mysterious island, rumored to be haunted by the spirits of pirates who had perished in a great battle. The island, shrouded in a perpetual mist, was said to hold the wreck of a Spanish galleon laden with gold. As they explored the island, they encountered more than just the remnants of the ship. The island was alive with the echoes of the past. Phantom ships appeared on the horizon, disappearing as quickly as they materialized. Ghostly figures roamed the beaches, reenacting battles long since fought. Captain Morgan, ever the pragmatist, remained skeptical of these supernatural occurrences, attributing them to tricks of light and the overactive imaginations of his crew. But even he could not deny the eerie feeling that gripped them as they delved deeper into the island's mysteries. Their search for the galleon's treasure led them to an underground cave system, where the line between legend and reality blurred even further. Here, they found not only the remnants of the galleon but also ancient artifacts that spoke of a time when the Caribbean was a crossroads of different civilizations, each leaving its mark on the islands. But the mysteries of the deep were not confined to hidden islands and ghostly apparitions. The Sea Serpent itself became the center of a strange occurrence when it sailed through an area known among sailors as the Devil's Triangle. Instruments malfunctioned, compasses spun wildly, and a thick fog enveloped the ship. In this disorienting environment, Captain Morgan's leadership was put to the test. The crew, rattled by the unexplainable phenomena, looked to their captain for guidance. Morgan, relying on his instincts and years of experience at sea, steered the ship through the chaos, emerging from the triangle with tales that would add to the Sea Serpent's mystique. The culmination of their journey through the mysteries of the deep was a confrontation with a rival pirate fleet led by a notorious captain known as the Siren of the Seas. She was a formidable adversary, her cunning and knowledge of the sea rivaling that of Captain Morgan. The battle that ensued was one of the greatest naval engagements of the age. Cannons roared, muskets fired, and swords clashed as the two pirate fleets fought for supremacy on the high seas. The Sea Serpent, with Captain Morgan at the helm, maneuvered through the chaos, its crew fighting with the ferocity of men possessed. In the midst of the battle, Captain Morgan faced the Siren in a duel on the deck of her ship. It was a clash of two titans, each master of their craft. The duel was intense and evenly matched until Morgan, with a clever feint, disarmed the Siren and claimed victory. The defeat of the Siren's fleet solidified Captain Morgan's reputation as the undisputed master of the seas. The respect he earned from this victory ensured a period of relative peace among the pirate factions, with many recognizing his authority and seeking his favor. Captain Morgan and his crew continued to sail the Caribbean, their legend growing with each passing day. They had faced the mysteries of the deep and emerged victorious, their names etched into the annals of pirate lore. The Sea Serpent, a symbol of their bravery and adventure, sailed into the sunset, its sails billowing in the wind, ready for the next adventure that awaited on the horizon. Chapter 4. The Sword Secret. As the legend of Captain Morgan and the Emerald Sword grew, the Caribbean became a chessboard of power struggles, with various factions vying for dominance. The Sea Serpent and its crew, now at the center of these tumultuous times, sailed towards their destiny, their course set for the mysterious Bermuda Triangle, where the final piece of the puzzle awaited. The Bermuda Triangle, a region shrouded in mystery and superstition, was said to be the resting place of the Emerald Sword. Captain Morgan, guided by the map they had discovered in the Haunted Islands cave and the knowledge gleaned from their previous encounters, knew that the key to finding the sword lay in deciphering the ancient rituals and celestial alignments described in pirate lore. As they entered the triangle, the seas grew turbulent, and a thick fog enveloped the ship. The crew, seasoned and fearless, stood firm, their trust in Captain Morgan unshaken. In the heart of the triangle, they encountered a maelstrom, a swirling vortex that threatened to swallow the ship whole. Captain Morgan, holding steadfast at the helm, navigated the Sea Serpent through the maelstrom with extraordinary skill. As they emerged from the other side, they found themselves in calm waters, under a sky lit by a constellation that mirrored the symbols on their map. They had found the hidden entrance to an underwater cavern, the final resting place of the Emerald Sword. Diving into the depths, Captain Morgan and a select group of his crew, including Black Bill and Inbani, discovered an ancient underwater temple, its architecture unlike anything they had seen before. It was here, in the heart of this forgotten temple, that they found the Emerald Sword, its blade encrusted with barnacles, yet still emanating a faint, otherworldly glow. As Captain Morgan reached out to claim the sword, the temple came alive with ancient magic. The sword, bound by an old curse, awakened the guardians of the temple, spectral warriors, remnants of the past, bound to protect the sword for eternity. A fierce battle ensued, with Captain Morgan and his crew fighting against these phantom adversaries. The sword, sensing the presence of worthy opponents, unleashed its true power, its emerald glowing brightly, illuminating the dark waters of the cavern. In the heat of battle, Captain Morgan grasped the sword, and a rush of knowledge and visions filled his mind. He saw the sword's creation, forged by a master swordsmith under a rare celestial event, its metal infused with a shard of a fallen star. He saw its history, passed down through generations of warriors and kings, each wielding its power to shape the destinies of nations. But with great power came great responsibility. The sword was not just a weapon, it was a key to an ancient mystical power that, if unleashed, could alter the very essence of the sea and the sky. The guardians, Captain Morgan realized, were not just protectors of the sword but also sentinels preventing its power from falling into the wrong hands. Understanding the magnitude of the sword's power, Captain Morgan made a pivotal decision. He chose not to wield the sword for personal gain but to safeguard its secret. In a decisive act, he used the sword to seal the temple, ensuring that its power would remain hidden, its secrets protected from those who would misuse it. As they emerged from the depths, the Sea Serpent's crew was met with awe and respect by their peers. The tale of their encounter with the Guardians and Captain Morgan's selfless act spread far and wide, solidifying his legend as not just a pirate but a protector of the seas. The story concludes with Captain Morgan returning to Port Royal, the Emerald Sword securely hidden away. He and his crew continued their adventures, their exploits becoming the stuff of legend, tales told in every corner of the Caribbean. Captain Morgan's legacy was not just that of a pirate, but of a man who stood at the crossroads of history and myth, a man who faced the mysteries of the past and chose the path of wisdom and restraint. The Emerald Sword of Captain Morgan became a legend, a symbol of power, responsibility, and the eternal allure of the sea. As the Sea Serpent sailed into the sunset, her sails billowing in the wind, Captain Morgan stood at the helm, a man who had touched the untold powers of the world and emerged wiser. His eyes were fixed on the horizon, ready for the next adventure, for the sea was his home, and its mysteries were his to explore.